and welcome to Boat Workshop. This is Shweta Roy, your English Master Teacher at Vedantu. And today, guys, we are going to deal with a topic which is very interesting and also very, very important, not just pertaining to your boat, that is Vedantu Online Talent Exam, but also, of course, for your future competitive exams, whatever competitive exams you give. Logical reason is something which is definitely going to find its way through your papers, right? So guys, about BOAT, you must be knowing that BOAT is Vedantu Online Talent Exam. It has already started from 28th March. It would continue till 18th April. And this is not just an exam. This is our comeback, right? So in today's session, we are going to master logical reasoning in 45 minutes only. That is your BOAT special. And this is me, your master teacher. Could go through my profile, and with that, guys, we will be entering very soon into the session. Please stay active and stay tuned throughout the session and try and give the answers in the chat box. Okay, so first of all, do let me know, can you all hear me? Can you all see me? Am I visible and audible to all of you? Yes, then give me a quick thumbs up in the chat. And now we would be starting with the very first question. So get ready to answer the very first question in the chat box. Okay? Okay, yes. Before delving into the session, guys, let me ask you one question. Where are you from? So please do write in the chat, where are you from, which part of India, which place. And I'm sure that most of you, or you know, a majority of you had got a setback to your learning. So was 2020 a setback to your learning? And of course, because of this pandemic, the entire process of education shifted from offline to online mode. And so many, you know, when we were not ready, okay, our schools were not ready for this shift. So definitely this caused a great confusion. This caused a great disturbance to your learning. So as a result, 2020 became a setback for all of us. But guys, don't worry, because we have pledged for your comeback, and this is your comeback moment, which starts now. So get ready for your comeback with Vedantu Online Talent Exam. Already two exams are over, 28th March and 4th April. Now the next exam is going to be on 11th April and 18th April. So two more to go, guys. Don't forget to register yourselves for BOAT, which is going to give you in-depth performance analysis with all India rank, guaranteed scholarship from a pool of over 500 crore, daily challenges which you can win, and that too worth rupees 1 crore. Also, you could stand a chance to be Vedantu CEO for a day and win a trip to NASA. So you can have in-depth performance analysis, and that is why I'm telling you this is a comeback for all of you, right? So you could have all India rank, subject-wise analysis, state-wise analysis, and question-level analysis, and also you could collect lot of free coins and win daily prizes. Okay, also standing a chance to win all expenses, you know, for educational trip to NASA in the United States. And you could win so many amazing and exciting prizes like drones, telescopes, laptops, and many more by taking up daily challenges. Become the CEO of Vedantu, that is India's leading live online learning platform, and you could share your ideas to change the way millions of students could learn online. So today's daily challenge, today's prize is Google Home Mini. And let's start with the very first question, guys. Now, you have to select the correct number which will replace the question mark. So this is the question 3:15 is proportional to 7:what? Okay, so you have to select the correct number which would be replacing the question mark. Options are 36, 135, 35, or 16. Quickly let me know in the chat box what do you think would be the correct answer. 36, 3:15 is proportional to 7:-. Okay, let's check. Let's have a look at the answer. It is 35. Okay, so 3:15 is proportional to 7:35. How do we get that? Very simple. 3 into 5 is 15. Then 7 into 5 definitely would be 35. So see, this is 3, right? And this is 15. So you multiply 3 with 5, you get 15. So similarly here also you have to, since you've multiplied here, so with the same number you have to multiply here, and that would be giving you the answer as 35. Very simple, right? So this was very simple. Now let's move ahead with the next question. Now this is a Venn diagram, guys, okay? which explains the correct relationship between math, chemistry, subject. Okay, so which of the following Venn diagram is explaining correctly the relationship between math, chemistry and subject? Okay, look at the options. Okay, A, B, C, D. So which one do you think would be correctly explaining math, chemistry and subject? Let's have a look at the answer. It is D. Because see, math and chemistry falls, these are both are subjects, right? So definitely they would be falling under the broad category of subject. Again, very, very simple. Okay? So math and chemistry, as I told you, they both are subjects. So subject is a broad criteria and within which falls math and chemistry. Theek hai bachcha baati? So I hope you people are rocking in all the questions so far. Was easy question. Let's have a look at the next one. Which of the following words cannot be formed by using the letters of the given word? Okay, so this is the letter concentrate. You have to mold and twist and tell me which word cannot be formed. Center, drain, race or treat. Which of the words won't be able to form with the word concentrate? Center, train, race or treat. Which one? Let's see. Very simple, guys. It is train. Why? Because there is no I here, right? Where is I in this concentrate? No I. So since we don't have I in concentrate, how can we form train? Very, very simple. Okay, so now let's move ahead with the next question. I hope you people are enjoying a lot. So please let me know in the chat box. Are you liking the question? Are you having fun? Okay, so let's move forward with the next question. So guys, before moving forward, do let me know, are you excited to make a comeback? Say yes. Okay, so if you want to know more, wait till the end of the class, or you could also download the Google app, okay, and visit this link vdnt.in/vdnt910e, okay, and these are the Telegram links, grade-wise Telegram links, so you could definitely join them. Okay, now moving ahead, let's move to the next one. Next question is, in a secret code, Apple is written as ELPPA. So, Apple is written as ELPPA. So, then you have to find out how can we write train. Okay? Is it NIATR or RTINA? NIART, NTIAR. So if we are writing Apple in this way, how would we write train? Of course, we have to follow the same logic which we have followed in Apple, which they have already followed in Apple. Very simple. Look at the word carefully. Okay, so let me give you the answer, guys. I hope many of you have got the answer. It is NIART. Let me tell you how. See, Apple is written as ELPPA, hai na? So it's just, you know, this one. This is the logic which is followed over here, right? So you have to follow the same logic. So just the opposite. ELPPA. Very, very simple. So, similarly, train would be NIART. Very, very simple. Hai na? Okay. Too simple. Let's move ahead. So, how many of you have got all of the answers correct till here? Give me a quick high five in the chat box. Chalo. Now, let's move ahead with the next one. So, which of the following diagrams illustrate the best relation between travelers, train and bus? Theek hai, travelers, train and bus. What do you think? Which one? A, B, C or D? Let's have a look. It is C. Okay, travelers travel by bus and train both, right? So they have a joint relation. So that is why it would be this one. Okay, travelers they travel by, some travelers travel by train, some travelers travel by bus. Okay, so train and bus both would be, I mean travelers would be common in both train and bus. Okay. Moving ahead, now you have to guess the missing number. Theek hai? So, 7, you could read it both ways. I mean, 7, 18, 12, question mark, 14, 9, 24, 42. Or 7, 42, 24, 9, 14, question mark, 12, 18. Okay. So, your options are 20, 49, 21, 45. What should come here? Think about it. Try to guess what logic has been followed. Okay, let's have a look at the answer. It is C, 21. Let's see how. So, it is by 2. 18 by 2 is 9, 14 by 2 is 7, 24 by 2 is 12, 42 by 2 is 21. So, it would be 21. Theek hai? So, all by 2, 18 by 2. Theek hai? 14 by 2. Understood? 18 by 2 is 9. Okay? So, here we have 9. Then, 14 by 2 is 7. So, here we have 7. Okay? Then, so therefore, 24 by 2 is 12. Therefore, we have here 12. So, it would be 42 by 2. That would be 21. So, all is by 2. Okay? So, this was a bit tricky. But I hope you have given me the correct answer. You could guess the correct answer. So, with that, we would be moving ahead with the next one. That is, in a secret code, Delhi. Now, again, this is alphabetical D-E-L-H-I. Delhi is written as E-F-M-I-J. Hai na? So, how would you write Bihar? Think about the logic which has been followed here. Same would be followed for Bihar. So, these are the options, guys. Which is the correct option? What do you think? Okay. 3, 2, 1. Let's see. Let's look at the answer. It is option number A, C-J-I-B-S. Let's check how. Okay, so guys, are we all set to make a comeback? Then we need to register for vote, right? So, how to vote? You just need to download the Vedantu Learning app, or you could visit this link, okay? And you could create your own voter ID card. You could choose your vote days, right? And then you could win main prizes and daily challenges. And also, you could join squads, you could earn V coins, get rewards, and create your own squad, win big. Okay? So, guys, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the session and I hope you've understood all the questions. Okay? So, now what you have to do is you need to register for vote. So, jaldi se bacha vaati, do register and make your comeback. Thank you so much, guys. Take care. Bye bye. See you very soon in the next session. Thank you.